Hello everybody, this is Joe. Thank you for watching my Giga Texas update video. I would like to thank Bradford Ferguson of Halter Ferguson Financial and all of my patrons for your outstanding support. It really does help make these videos possible. So on the 6th November video that Randy put out, a member of our quad squad, a lot of people noticed this area up sort of southeast of the steel structure and wondering what was going on. Did they strike oil? Was there groundwater seeping up? Is it a disaster? Is Giga Texas going to be doomed? What's going to happen? So why don't we take a closer look and see if we can answer that. This image shows you the area that we're talking about. Again, it's sort of southeast of the big pavilion. I've got it in the circle, and the highlighted area I've noticed in several of my previous videos that this area has never had GeoPier work done, and it stands out with the rest of that foundation because, as you know, a lot more GeoPier has been done, and they're working on the west side too. So why didn't they do this area? Well, if we look back on my 31 July picture, you'll see here that this was a very big swamp area, and it's sort of unique to the rest of the foundation area, and this may explain it. So what they're doing, because of that poor soil due to that pond, is that they're adding a concrete slurry mix to the GeoPier holes. And if you can look closely here, you see them actually adding it and having the arrows showing where other holes are. And they're filling it with this cement grout mixture. And then once they fill it up to a certain amount, then they put some aggregate in there, and then the impactor that you see here in the video will come in and start impacting it like we've seen everywhere else. But this time it's got that grout within the mix. And if you look here in the circled area, you can see there's the concrete truck, there's the green and the white little pumps that take that grout mixture from the truck, puts it through those pipes, and it goes over, and you can saw those guys kind of holding in that other circle the pipe, and then they're filling up the hole. So I would like to just do a real quick review from my 16 August video on GeoPier again. I would recommend you go back and look at that video. But the ramp aggregate pier system has the machinery you see on the left. They put in the aggregate, they make the footing, they make those pillars, and then it supports the foundation. And as we know, the reason why they're doing GeoPier is it's a way of reinforcing poor soils. Basically, it's a low-cost way of making sure that the foundation is supported. It can go down about 40 feet deep. And then highlighted here, and we talked about it on the 16th August, but we haven't seen it to this point, is they can put a cementous mixture within that to help improve the stiffness and support. So here's additional information that comes from the GeoPier system website, and you can see the link on the slide. It will be in the video as well. They put more grout in because it stiffens the pier. It provides more long-term confinement of that pillar. It, again, as we talked about, the grout is introduced to a certain depth, aggregates put in, then the ramming process begins like we've been seeing, but this time with that cement mixture. And that grout binds with the compacted aggregate, and it strengthens the pier through weak soil zones. And as we saw with the pond area there, this soil is particularly weak on the foundation. So I hope that this little discussion explains a little bit about what we saw in Randy's 6 November video, why we're going to continue to see that in that northeast corner of the foundation to help strengthen that, and just answers the question, is Giga Texas okay, and can we progress on construction? So anyway, hope this was helpful. So if you have any questions, let me know. Okay, my drones are fully charged and they are ready. Let's go flying over Giga Texas.
Thank you.